that Robert had a dart in all three of those legs. So it could have gone the other way. And Bunton could have found himself losing that first set 3-0, but it didn't. All ifs and buts. And now it's Bunton. And you would expect for him to push on from here.
Well, he really has had a fabulous year. Joined the PDC in January, and he won his first tournament after 2 days on tour. His second event shows you how good he is. Now number 25 in the world. Broken into the top 32 within 11 months. So everything for the next 13 months will just see Bunting jump place after place. He could easily, Rod, be in the top 10 this time next year.
Very easily. Like you say, he's defended nothing on the world ranking list. So a good performance in this tournament could push him near the top 16 straight away anyway. It's a tough call on the tour and everything, but a class player like Stephen is. We've got plenty of bottle, to be quite honest. That was unlucky.
87.
And that leaves tops.
Robert, you require 146.
Looking for a treble 20. We'll stay there. Third time lucky?
65.
Well, that's a pointless exercise going for the bullseye, but there you go. Probably academic anyway.
Game Sean, a first
set
leg
to the good. Now a leg to the good in the second set.
Second
and
leg,
that
Stephen
was more like it.
First.
Trying a bit
Game
quicker. Look better there. Look more confident.
But you're right, what you said about Robert going for the 25. I mean, all right, if he hits the bullseye, that helps. But why not go for a treble? You know, the extra 5 points of hitting the 20 leaves you 86. There's no difference between 86 and 81, to be quite honest.
With a bullseye at 12.7 millimetres in diameter is the smallest target on the board. Why we continue to keep going for it, I don't know. He's good on the treble 20, he's just hit another maximum. Robert, stop going for the bullseyes, man.
99.
Go on then, and another. Yes.
Ah. 81.
We're going to see one. Don't worry, all you fans back home. I can assure you there'll be a 9 data before the end of January the 4th when the final will be
98.
On.
Are you guaranteeing a 9 data, Rodney?
Yes, kind of.
What do you mean kind of? You can't kind of guarantee it. Right, yes or no? Come on.
Yes.
Oh, did you hear that?
100. Stephen, you require 100.
There's too much quality in this event for there not to be a 9 dart leg.
I've got to say, I agree with you.
85. Robert, you require 140.
Treble. He's playing well, isn't he? Another.
100. Stephen, you require 82.
Well, this is a nice checkout. Bullseye leaves him 32. Is it that bullseye? Now 32.
Game
oh, good. Clean
end.
Kill, as we call it. And do you know what? Robert, again, he's only like first. One dart away. He was only one dart away in the first set, and again in this set.
He really is, and you're right. There's a dart behind in every single lane. Again, his first dart is very good. He just knows it 2180s, but he doesn't seem to follow the first dart enough. He's not the best grouper in the world. He's just very straight, Robert. He played superbly well, like I said, in the World Cup in 2013.
81.
So we know he can play. He's averaging 88. Stephen is averaging 90.
So overall, the qualifiers this year have been excellent. You know, they've been at a great standard, showed plenty of enthusiasm, plenty of bottle on the stage. And then when they've played the seeds, They've given them a good go, and of course, as Wes Newton and Justin Piper found
97.
Out, and Paul Nicholson, I believe.
Yeah, they're no longer also Rens, are they? Let's be honest. They're quality players now. It's good to see. It's what the game's all about, Rodney.
It certainly is. And let's be honest, Wayne, when we did the draw and we're giving people qualifiers, they're saying to the TV, cheers, boys. Thanks very much. Because they think it's an... Well, it is an easier round, but not so easy.
174.
Magnifique. Superb. Good players
55.
Do the right thing at the right time. Marjanovic keep going for bullseyes, doing the wrong thing at the wrong time.
60.
Wayne, you know, he had a dart quite good on the treble 19. The treble 19 would have left in the straight 100. Perhaps his coach or mentor needs just to make him aware.
64. Stephen, you require 32.
What that 25 is doing to him, so... Double 16 again for the set.
Second set.
A quick set for Stephen Bunting again. He won the first set 3-0. He's won this one 3-0. Stephen Bunting, the Lakeside champion, is on a run and heading for the second round here at the World Championship.